It's dark. It's cold. It's bluish. There is distinct chatter saying that you are not alone. There is fish, a lot of them. You came outside. There are people walking, talking, doing their things. There is the sunlight struggling to pierce the water to reach you. You know, you are underwater. To be precise, you are an underwater citizen, an advanced aquanaut. Your ancestors used to live on the land, but now you are living with the ocean species as a part of this enormous underwater civilization. Really? Is it going to happen? Do we live in oceans in the future? Can we survive there? Approximately 70% of Earth's surface is covered by the ocean, and the ocean itself consists of 80% deep sea. Living in oceans can be the solution for many crises related to food, energy, water, carbon dioxide, and natural resources. Underwater cities and countries can be a reality because there are high chances of food scarcity due to rapid increase in population, increasing farmlands, climate change, globalization demands a high amount of energy. To meet the needs of humans, underwater living can be a promising solution. Living underwater could also help give scientists a better understanding of the planet and the evolution of life on Earth. Experts predict there could be an unquantifiable amount of minerals and metals that could be used to improve humanity and even help with further construction of underwater cities. But living underwater isn't such an easy thing as it sounds. There are some challenges that we have to face before having a fully furnished underwater civilization. First one is to enable humans to breathe underwater. We have to provide oxygen along with other gases. We need to take extra measures to ensure that there is a healthy ratio of oxygen to other gases in the air, as the body requires varying levels of different air components when at pressure. Seawater in tropical regions with abundant plant life contains only 5 to 8 milligrams of dissolved oxygen per liter of water. If we have to develop a system that enables us to breathe underwater, at least 92 liters of seawater would have to be passed through the system. Humans can develop artificial gills to breathe just like fishes, but this requires an advanced study of our biology. For energy, we can use solar panels on the surface of the ocean to transfer energy to the city inside. Other way is ocean thermal energy conversion, which generates electricity via a heat engine that takes advantage of differences in temperature between water on the ocean surface, which is heated by sun, and cold deep water. For fresh water, we can use the reverse osmosis membrane desalination. This is a type of filter membrane that uses the pressure differences in water. Or we can transport water from land to deep sea through pipes. Right now, we have the ability to create underwater habitats. We have enough technology to build them. It was the iconic ocean explorer Jacques Cousteau who made this idea a reality. The structures called conch shells, which he designed, allowed oceanauts to live underwater for days or even weeks at a time at 100 meters depth. Architects at Shimizu Corporation have already designed $26 billion project to create an underwater city. According to the company, their project would allow thousands of humans to live very comfortably underwater. But to this date, we explored only 3% of the ocean. According to NASA, it's easier to send a person to space than it is to send them below ocean surface. That's why we have better maps of Mars but not Earth's own ocean floors. Underwater cities are not a concern today. But living underwater could help save the human species in the case of major apocalyptic event. My dear people of Earth, please put some force on the subscribe button because it's crying.